I feel like I'm in a really dumb enchanted forest or something behind these little adapters. Today's GPU, sorry, this week's GPU or this half week's GPU, I don't know how I'm going to dump these videos because this card is pretty new and relevant, so I'm probably going to dump the video a little early. This is an NVIDIA GeForce RTX 4080 Super. This is 8103's kind of big boy, full fat GPU. I have some custom CAT here that's been installed on this bad boy, but you can see the blacked out design, really what this thing is, it's a 4080 at a little bit less MSRP. So this is a Founders Edition, picked it up from Best Buy with my own money, yes. And let's take a look at the hash rates because honestly, it's probably the best 40 series I've looked at so far. And what I mean by that is you can see a lot of green. Sorry, the chat's still visible from when I was doing my live stream here. Let me shut that off. Perfect, back to the content. There aren't really any massively wildly weighted, you know, green versus orange or green versus red sides like there is on a card like the 4060 Ti, where the efficiency is always really good, but the hash rate is just not there for density. This thing has a pretty good case to make for itself on everything as far as efficiency and density is concerned, but it really only makes sense, in my opinion, to look at for mining right now versus something like a couple or a trio of 3070s. If you need something with a warranty, if you are only interested in buying something new and not deal hunting, or if you just can't support 3070s. That being said, there are a lot of things that this does where it's more equivalent to 1.5 or 2 3070s, and there's very little that this actually bests the 3070 on efficiency. And Nexa is one of those things that does 0.763 mega hash per watt, and that is bananas. I think that's the best hardware confirmed efficiency I've ever seen. It's really close to the 4090 and I think the 4070 non-super, but that data is so old I don't trust it. So I'm rerunning it, but it's definitely better than the 4070 super, which you'll see soon. Flux efficiency, just wildly good. 0.570, tremendous. Anything over 0.5 is, I think, really quite good. 0.55 is exquisite. So that's excellent, and that was still pushing 78 souls. I mean, you would need a pretty well-tuned 3080 10 gig to match that kind of hash rate, and you wouldn't be seeing the same efficiency with that card. So really quite good, but this thing will pack a punch. I mean, we were pulling 104 souls out of it with almost no efficiency loss, and that's like a 3090. So, I mean, this really... It still has a pretty significant memory bus throughput, and it has a pretty good core, even though the actual silicon die is not very big. 8103 is just not a very big piece of silicon. So Nexa, really, really great hash rate. Again, as I said, the efficiency is bananas. Dynex, we did get good efficiency, but not stellar efficiency, and we did get great hash rate, but not at the same time. However, you can see 55, almost the same efficiency, so you definitely, in my opinion, would be better off just running these things pretty much a lot harder. The VRM is a little bit of a concern on the 4080 Super Founders Edition specifically, so maybe avoid the FE if you're going to be mining more power-intensive algorithms on them. Alephium, tremendous hash rate. This thing is pulling down 3 3070s worth of hash rate at better than 3070 efficiency in a lot of cases. It's very close. KYLA coin, I don't know if the hash rate's good. Same with Ironfish. I don't mine them, so I don't have a good sense for what's good and bad for density, but I do know what's good and bad for efficiency. KYLA's reasonable, and Ironfish is very good. So 150 is kind of the cutoff for Ironfish, and 9 is actually my cutoff for KYLA coin, but it's 8.85, so I let it slide. Radiant, good. This is 20% over what I would deem efficiency being good at. 2.1 kilohash. Pretty good. I mean, you can do your own research on what cards you're looking at and what kind of hash rate they get, but I mean, this is like 3.5 3070s tuned for efficiency, so that's quite good. Karlsen, again, hash rate packs a serious punch. Efficiency is ruthlessly good. It's almost double what I would consider the threshold for good efficiency. So this card, I think, actually will be going on unminable to KLS, at least for a while for me. Ergo, really solid hash rate. Very good efficiency, but not the best we've seen. ETC, great efficiency, but the memory, pardon me, you really had to push way too hard to get 100 mega hash out of this. the efficiency took a serious nosedive. So 0.385 is like 20 series efficiency on ETH, so not great there. But if you just want an efficient 90 mega hash, this card's here for you. Pigeon coin, again, the hash rate's pretty okay, but the efficiency is pretty bad. And this is the first NVIDIA card I've tested since the CMP170HX, and that I didn't have hardware numbers for, so it could be way off. This is the first NVIDIA card I've tested in a long time that gets reliably over 0.2 megahash per watt, which is, it's really good. This is better efficiency than a 5700 XT at double the hash rate. So again, if you're comparing it though, two 5700 XTs is like $300. This is almost $1,100 after tax. So I always come back to, it depends on what you're going to mine with it, but there are cases, I understand, where you just need the density, you need a card with warranty, or you just want one thing that can do everything. So if these were $600, no brainer, but they're not. All right, Cortex, Conflux, great efficiencies, Conflux, good hash rate. So there's the sheet. You guys can decide what makes sense for your mining needs. I haven't tested this on any sort of synthetics for gaming or anything like that, but honestly, it's probably the most impressive, well-rounded Ada desktop GPU I've seen so far. So we'll get going on the 4070 Super next time, and then I do still have to rerun the 4070, but that will all be fairly shortly. And now that I have the datasets built out, rerunning and adding algos will be much easier and much quicker. So thanks everyone that joined me for the initial live stream for this card and for this little summary video. Now, but yeah, I'll see you on the weekend or midweek or something like that. Thank you as always for watching, and goodbye.